hear my prayer. Listen to my heart's cry. For no matter where I am, even when I'm far from home, I will cry out to you for a father's help. When I'm feeble and overwhelmed by life, guide me into your glory, for I am safe and sheltered. Lord, you are a paradise of protection for me. You lift me high above the fray. None of my foes can touch me, and when I'm held firmly in your wrapped around presence, keep me in this glory. Let me live continually under your splendor shadow, hiding my life in you forever.
Thank you for changing not only my career but my life with this song. I appreciate it. This is called "Fading On So Far."
Off.
share a few remarks with you this morning. And I would like to go to the book of Ecclesiastes. It's one of my favorite books. And the writer of Ecclesiastes, he has this kind of reality that is easy to understand, but you know what he's talking about. And it's in chapter 7, verse 2. The writer says, it is better to go to a house of mourning than to go to a house of feasting, for death is the destiny of every man. The living should take heart. You know, I was standing in this same pulpit last Saturday doing the same thing, and it just kind of, the reality starts sitting in that, you know, that we've all got an appointment with death, and there's not a lot we can do about it. We can try our best, live our best, but the bottom line is, it's coming. And in chapter 3, verse 2, the writer says, there is a time for everything and a season for every activity under heaven, a time to be born, a time to die, and a time to plant, and a time to uproot. As I was gathering my thoughts about Tim Weed, I've known him since 1986, I believe it was, 1985. And we used to work at Winn-Dixie together, and that's where I got to know Tim real well. And then I joined the Army in 86 and kind of lost touch with him. But that's how I know Tim through the years. And Kathy is Gloria's first cousin, so we kind of kept tabs on Tim. But as I was listening to the family on what kind of words would you use to describe Tim, you know, his son, Gavin, said, just make sure you mention that he had a big heart, that he would give you the shirt off his back if he could. And I don't think there's no greater compliment than you could give someone that they've got a big heart. And he would help anyone any way he could. And this is what I didn't understand. Somebody said that he loved yard work. I have to kind of wrap my right. Love yard work. And he loved deep sea fishing. And I can't do that. And the previous, I really don't like to do it. My wife will attest to that. But those are great attributes of Tim, but basically today is it's a time for us to kind of say our goodbye to Tim, and it's not always easy to do that, but it somehow gives us a little bit of closure. He's always going to live in your hearts. You always have his memory to hang on to and the memories that you created with him. But the bottom line is this, we're all going to go this route one day. But I think what Solomon was saying in Ecclesiastes 7, verse 2, is he was trying to ground us in the fact that we're all fragile human beings. We're all flawed. And we're all just trying to find our way back home. And if there's anything that I have gleaned from my years of studying the Bible to the best of my ability, Jesus frowns on anybody trying to condemn or judge people, because that's left to death makes us reflect on our lives more than a party does. I mean, think about it. Do you think about things during a funeral or a death that you haven't thought about all year? I know I do, and I look back and say, could I do something different? Because I don't want my life filled with regret, you know, and hopefully when we finish up this life, it'll be filled with hope and expectation and a better tomorrow. And as we sit here today, I would like to challenge us all just to reflect on our own lives and ask ourselves, you know, could I do something different? Could I finish this race differently? That I don't end with a lot of regrets. And there's one story that really stands out, and this is in John, and I'm not going to read the whole scripture, but Mary and Martha sinned for Jesus to please come because their brother Lazarus is dying. So they're sitting there pretty much on pins and needles, and Jesus gets to work. And Jesus doesn't rush back. Matter of fact, it takes him 4 days to get back there. And, you know, and it's, if you study the Bible, you see that the shortest scripture in the Bible is Jesus wept. And I've often wondered why Jesus wept at Lazarus' tomb, because he was about to raise him from the dead. So I've always been a little, I read and questioned it, but the bottom line is, you know, it's okay to have questions for God, and, you know, and because God already knows you're thinking them, you know, so it's okay to have those questions for God. And it's hard for us to, you know, wrap our minds around certain things, how, you know, one person takes this direction, another person takes that direction, and, you know, life is just filled with questions, and most of the time it's filled with more questions than it is answers. And the bottom line is, you know, today we're here to pay tribute to Tim and his life. And it's okay to be flooded with emotions. It's okay to weep. It's okay to cry, because Jesus himself wept. So, but the bottom line is that this is coming to us all. This time is coming to us all. And if you don't do anything after this service, but just reflect on your life and, you know, am I going to get to the end of my life and be filled with a lot of regrets? And hopefully, like I said, the good news is that, you know, I didn't realize Tim had got to the point that his back pain was so bad that he was bent over double. And, you know, the good news is he don't have back pain anymore. He don't have that suffering anymore. And, you know, there's just, you know, God does a lot with us when we leave this place and go to the next one. And my prayer is that Tim he'll be in peace and be pain free, and that he'll be looking down upon his son and his family and smiling on them. And hopefully you can just sense Tim's presence around from this day forward. And with that being said, I want to close in a word of prayer. God, there's a lot of things we don't understand. There's a lot of things that when death does knock on our door, it's just something that we're not naturally equipped to deal with. But through your presence, through your power, God, you give us the strength to be able to put one foot in front of the other and just keep pressing on. And I think if there's anything or any kind of message you have for us today, is just to find our strength in you and just keep putting one foot in front of the other and just keep pressing on toward home. And God, we love you and we thank you, God, for your many blessings. And God, we just pray your blessings to be upon this family. May your presence just rest heavily in their midst as they reflect on their times with their brother or their father, grandfather. And God, we just love you. We thank you and praise you. In Christ's name.